All right. So you took all of this and you substituted it in place of that y. Now you have all x's. But you have a fraction here. Some kids change this to 1.5, which is okay. You can do that. But the way I would do it is I would clear my denominator. And so what I would do here, I would multiply everything by 2. So when I multiply everything by 2, the 2's are going to cancel out right there. And that's the whole purpose of it. Now, you're going to get negative 2x plus 20 is equal to 3x plus 16. Any questions about what I did so far? Again, this is called the method of substitution. And if you didn't learn it last year, you need to know it now, okay? So draw your line. I would add 2x to both sides. So I get 20 is equal to 5x plus 16. You should know how to solve a two-step equation. Now, some kids go after the 20. That's not right. The numbers with the x are the ones you want to get rid of. So I'm going to subtract 16, and then I'm going to divide by 5. I'm going to say it again. Subtract 16, so that gives me 4, and then I'm going to divide by 5, and that gives me my x. Now on your calculator, take 4 divided by 5, and you should get 0.8. Any questions on how I got my x? Now that I have my x, I got to find my y. Okay, I'm only halfway finished. So you get to pick. You can pick this one to get your y, or you can pick this one. This one looks easier to me, so I'm going to say y equals negative x plus 10. I'm going to substitute 0.8, so I get y equals negative 0.8 plus 10. And then I get my calculator, 10 minus 0.8 should be 9.2. This is called your x and y intercept. It's where the two lines cross. Any questions on the method of substitution? All right, now I'm going to let you try one. And again, if you're going to Algebra 2, then you're expected to be able to do this. So try this next one, please. Substitute and try and work it. I'll give you a few minutes to do that. I don't want to give you too much time because some of you are going home and you're not doing your work, and then you want to get credit right away or you want to get credit the next day. And technically, I might wait a while before I give you credit so that 0 sits on there. Why?
Correct. That's exactly right. Now you want to clear your denominator. So multiply all of those by 3, and that 3 is going to drop out. And then you're going to have variables on both sides, and then you're going to go down to a two-step equation. I'm going to give you one more minute to do what you can do. Again, you're going to multiply everything by 3 to clear your denominator. Then you're going to have variables on both sides. So get rid of one of the x's. And then you're going to have a two-step equation, which you should be able to work at that point. All right, let me have your attention. We're going to substitute the x minus 4 in place of that y. So it's going to be x minus 4
equals. Draw your line. You want to get rid of this fraction, so multiply by 3. When you multiply by 3, that cancels. So you're going to get 3x minus 12 equals 5x plus 6. Any questions on what I did so far? Now you got variables on both sides. You got 3x's over here and 5x's there. I would subtract 3x from this side and subtract 3x from that side. So I get negative 12 is equal to 2x plus 6. Again, we got a two-step equation, subtract 6. Now, when I say subtract 6, you end up adding these up because the signs are the same. So that's a negative 18 equals 2x. When you divide by 2, you get a negative 9. Any questions on what I said or what I did so far? This is part of today's work, okay? Now you got to find out the other one. So go back and substitute right here. Put a negative 9 right here. So a negative 9 plus a negative 9 minus 4 is actually a negative 13. So put a negative 13 for the y. You get to pick either one you want, but nobody picks this one. Put it right here. So it's negative 9 minus 4 is a negative 13. All right, one last thing. Let's say, now don't write this down, just listen. Let's say I have a problem like this. Let's say I have 2 over 5x plus 4 is equal to 1 over 3x minus 7. I already did my substitution, but what do I do now? Do I multiply everything by 5? Do I multiply everything by 3? What do I do? Well, what you do is you put these together. 5 times 3 gives you 15. So you want to multiply everything by 15. And let me tell you why. When you multiply everything by 15, that 5 is going to be absorbed inside that 15. So watch what I do. 5 goes into 15 3 times. 3 times 2 is 6. 15 times 4, I guess, is 60. You can check that. Now watch again. 3 goes into 15 5 times, so this would be 5x. And then whatever that is, 105 or whatever it is. And then subtract 5x and finish it up. So what I'm saying is, if they give you two denominators, put them together and then multiply each one by both of them. Yes?
Why did you multiply 2 by 3?
Because 5 goes into 15 how many times? 3 times 2 is what? That's the way you do it. Okay? All right. One last problem. Open up your book to page 776, please. All right, now I'm going to read this while you get set up. So here I go. Guys, if you're talking while I'm teaching, I'm going to record that in the gradebook, okay? Because two people were doing that. Make sure you're quiet while I'm teaching, okay? It says, use the given information to determine if the quadrilateral is best described by a trapezoid, a rectangle, a rhombus, or a square. So you got to pick which one it is. Let me show you how to do it. It's not hard, okay? First, it says quadrilateral A, B, C, D. So draw, start off with a rectangle and label it A, B, C, D. I like to see a picture, so I want you to draw that picture for all of these, okay? So draw that rectangle and let me show you how to work this. Savannah, you going to draw it?
Yeah.
All right, now look up here. It says the slope of AB right here. The slope of AB is negative 2. So put a negative 2 for your slope. It tells you the slope of BC, which is the top, is 1/2. It tells you that the slope of CD is -2. And then finally, DA or AD is 1/2. It tells me that AB, from here to here, the distance, is the square root of 20. Right here, the square root of 20. It tells me BC, the top, is the square root of 45. It tells me this side right here, CD, right here, is the square root of 20. And finally, it tells me the bottom, the distance, is the square root of 45. Now, let me explain some reasoning here. Look up here. These two sides have the same slope. Therefore, this side is parallel to that side. The top and bottom have the same slope. That means the top and bottom are parallel. It is not a trapezoid. A trapezoid only has one pair of parallel sides. Now, a rhombus and a square have all sides congruent. This one does not have all sides congruent. Therefore, it's got to be a rectangle. Look right here. This side is square root of 20, and this one is different. But these are the same, so it's a rectangle, and that's all it can be. And that's how you're going to work this section. You're going to draw the diagram. You're going to look. Are all the sides equal? If all the sides are equal, it's either a rhombus or a square. If one side is not parallel, it's got to be a trapezoid. Okay? Because the other ones are called parallelograms, where all the opposite sides are parallel. A trapezoid has one of them that's not parallel. All right. Anyway, here's your assignment for today. And I'm going to put this on video so that you understand if you don't finish today in class, that you will finish tonight. So copy that down. If you turned in some work or took a test or whatever, I plan on looking at it on Friday. Okay, so you'll have to sit with that zero or whatever until I get to it. When you guys are working on computers, that's a perfect time for me to catch up. If you don't like your mom seeing a zero on the computer, do your work. And I'm not sitting here trying to mark you down. I just want you to do work. All right, let me videotape these pages in case you need them for tonight. 774.